Good morning, everyone. We can stand up for us to start our service.
Thank you for your presence this morning. thank you for being with us to celebrate the lives of our beloved Serge and Marie-Agne. I will now give you the order of the service. We will start with the gospel reading, followed by a eulogy, then a song, followed by another eulogy, then homily, blessing, and the final hymn. Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the Father of mercies, the God of all consolation, be with you all.
And also with you.
Once again, good morning, everyone. We shall listen to a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have also faith in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again to take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus. Please be seated. We shall now go to the moment of the eulogy. With the first song, no?
Angelique.
The first song.
Hello all. I'm so sad to be standing here today, but also so privileged. I stand here for Herve, our children and grandchildren. Granny and Papa, as they were known to us, were so much part of our lives that it is hard to imagine how it will be without them. Herve has told me many times how everything he has achieved in life is because of his parents. By their example, they taught him to have a high work ethic, commitment, high standards, and loyalty. These are all lessons he learned growing up with them. His mom, while she was the softer parent, was also the one to guide him and teach him that you always have to do the right thing. So much so that when he was the only boy in his class that was not called up to the army in South Africa, which was compulsory after you completed school, his mom phoned the army and said, "Hey, you left out my son." Herve promptly got his call-up letter, and the next week, off to the army, he went for 2 years. He has always said that while this was hard at the time, it was one of the best learning experiences of his life. His dad might have been the disciplinarian and stricter parent. For instance, there was no going out on a Saturday to play with friends until all your chores were done, like painting, cutting the grass, etc. However, when Herve wanted to buy a motorbike, his dad said to him, "Well, then you need to save for it," which he did by getting odd jobs after school and working on Saturdays. When Herve had saved enough money, he went to his dad and told him he now had enough money to buy the bike. Serge took him to buy the bike, but then Serge paid for the bike and told Herve to keep his money. He wanted him to know that if you want something in life, need to work hard for it. When I met Herve and we became serious, I was instantly made to feel like their own child, like the daughter they never had. There are always the mother-in-law jokes, but I never felt that way about my mother-in-law. She was always the one that I went to solve problems and to talk to, even if it was to complain about her son. She always took my side. As for my father-in-law, he might not have been a man of many words, but he was the true embodiment of actions speak louder than words. He was reliable, thoughtful, warm, and always there for them. He was the man who would arrive with a stainless steel, handmade nappy drying rack that he had made himself when I was pregnant with his first grandchild. And whatever Serge did, he did it properly and to last. I still have that drying rack 31 years later. And now to speak of both of them as grandparents, a more loving and dedicated set of grandparents you couldn't get. Once Claude and Simon were born, everything was about them. They were truly the light of their lives. True to form, when the boys grew up and added to our circle, first with Melissa and a few years later with Celia, they made no distinction. They just added two more grandchildren to their lives. Once retirement came and their lives slowed down a bit, the spark that gave them immeasurable joy in their retirement years was when Melissa and Paul had their great granddaughter Chloe. She truly gave them so much joy and happiness, it was very special to witness. I once read that when a parent has another child, their heart does not divide, it multiplies. I can really say that Granny and Papa embodied this. The more we added to our family circle, we never felt we got less attention or love from them. They just gave us more. Family Sunday lunches, that has been our tradition for the last 30-odd years, might never be the same without them. But while we will miss having them there, we will keep them ever close to our hearts and continue to talk about them and make sure they are remembered and loved as we continue to add to our circle and multiply our love. Granny and Papa's place is always with us.
You looked down into her brown eyes and said, say a prayer for me. She threw her arms around me and whispered, you have to sleep. They could hear the riders coming and said, this is my last fight. If they take me back to Texas, they won't take me back alive. Well, there were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. They were praying for the lovers in the valley of the guns. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. Seven Spanish angels took another ring. She reached down and picked the gun up that lay smoking in his hand. She said, Father, please forgive me. I can make it without my man. And she knew the gun was empty
and she knew she couldn't win. But the final prayer was answered when the rifles cried again. There were 7 Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. They were praying for the lovers in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. And 7 Spanish angels took another angel home. There were 7 Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. They were praying for the lovers in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. And 7 Spanish angels took another angel home. 7 Spanish angels took another angel.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'll be reading on behalf of Serge sisters and brothers. I'm Marie-Agne, his niece. Serge Antoine Houareau was born on the 40th of August 1943. He came from a family of 7 from Guadalajara. He was the 2nd child and 2nd son. He attended a super school and proceeded to St. Clair. His first job was at Seychelles Cable and Wireless. His early years, he spent it at Guadalajara with his parents, brothers and sisters, and most of their time they spent it on the beach around the vicinity of Iloa, which for them, while growing up, was a magical time. He and his brother Jacques seems to get into the most mischief while growing up. One of the sisters remembers that each time they would gather as a family at night, next to their parents' bed for prayers, Serge and Jacques, during prayer time, will secretly plan the next day adventure while the others were busy praying. He was a quiet and loving brother, and he was very proud of his siblings. His sister Nadine remembered him scolding her once as she was frowning. "Stop worrying," he said. "Everything will work out in the end." Serge met his wife Marie-Agne around the same time his sister Marinette met her husband Roger, and the 4 of them forged a strong bond and would visit each other in South Africa, where they spent most of their working life. In South Africa, he worked for South African breweries as fitter and turner, and when he returned back to Seychelles in 1995, he took the job with the Seychelles breweries, then with Island Motors, Customs, and retires later on. He passed away at the age of 80 early this October, leaving behind his son, Hebe, his daughter, Eileen, daughter-in-law Eileen, 2 grandsons, 1 great-granddaughter. Surviving him, his siblings are 2 brothers, Daniel and Alan, 2 sisters, Marinette and Nadine. We bid goodbye to a man who has lived a very fruitful and long life, was admired by his family, and will be greatly missed. Fly high, and may both of your soul rest in eternal peace. Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Again, today we gather to bid a heartfelt farewell to Marie-Agne and Serge. I'm Georgette, Marie-Ange's youngest sister, and I would like to share some nice memories of this remarkable couple who shared a love that spanned 58 years. Their first home after being married was actually right next to where we are saying goodbye to them today. Marie-Ange, fondly known as Marie-Ange, was a generous and kind-hearted person. I remember her visiting us during my teenage years, bringing beautiful gifts from South Africa, especially lovely clothes for us. She was known for her kindness, zest for life, love for music, and joy in every moment. Later, when I moved in with them in South Africa, Serge, her husband, had his hands full. I, along with his sister Nicole and Marie-Ange herself, were always up to some mischief. I have a vivid memory of one incident where Marie-Ange was cooking a civet de canard, and the wine was flowing and music blaring. Marie-Anne, you are watching, you will remember that. All of a sudden, the pressure cooker exploded, and there were duck parts all over the kitchen, and we were obviously drunk and giggling when Serge, who had just finished a double shift at work, walked in, and you can imagine the chaos that ensued. Myself and Nicole had to stay away for about 2 weeks. Marie-Ange and myself enjoyed playing at the casino, which led to an interesting encounter with the law one night in South Africa. Percy was caught speeding, and we were being judged in a police bus. I distinctly recall Marie-Ange sharing a cigarette with the policeman while I invited the others to Seychelles on holiday. We miraculously got off spot-free and continued our journey to the Wild Coast, sun. Marie-Ange and Serge loved their family unconditionally. Their love for their only son, Hervé, was unparalleled, and they considered Eileen, as Marie-Ange would often say, the daughter they never had. Their grandchildren were the treasures of their lives. Despite facing challenges, including Serge's minor stroke, they remained close, as we say in Creole, la croix XLK. They were inseparable. Marie-Ange had been particularly happy lately with the arrival of her beloved great-grandchild, Chloe, whom they both adored. We were fortunate to spend a beautiful and fun day with her in August, creating cherished memories, all of us sisters, on our yearly lunch date, which we will always hold these memories dear. Serge, on the other hand, was a bit of a loner, a quiet man who enjoyed his own company and loved building things. Many of us remember having a Serge-built barbecue braai in the 80s in South Africa. Some is always recall his iconic red fiberglass Jeep, built by his own hand driving around Azwayan. He continued to find joy in his workshop even recently. Marie-Ange was deeply respected by many, evident in the countless individuals who reached out to express their gratitude for her help, mentorship, and the positive impact she had on their lives. She served the Seychelles government in various senior positions and held a wholesome life despite the challenges and troubles she faced. They were great godparents to my son Warren, and he will miss the calls and advice from Tante. There is so much more we could say about this remarkable couple who left us suddenly to continue their journey together. As we gather here today, we are all fortunate in some way to have known Marie-Ange or Serge. I have no doubt that they are with us today, smiling at the beautiful memories we've shared. Marie-Ange couldn't find a peace on earth with a sister like me, she always told me, so she found a private space where she can rest. However, sister, as I told you, Dr. Dauphé, the Mrs. Know-All you called me, will miss our consultations. Rest in peace, Marie-Ange and Serge, until we meet again.
We are invited to hear the words of Jesus addressed especially to the family this morning. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God. We know it's a very difficult moment to have lost two very special people at such a close interval. And when this happens, you're not prepared, because it wasn't planned. It never is, unfortunately. And so, in times like this, we have to turn to God and allow Him to be God in our lives. And the word He addresses to us is, do not let your hearts be troubled. You know that God is amazing, He's good, He's love, and He sees what's going on in our lives and in our hearts. He understands us better than ourselves. So we ask Him to console us in this very difficult moment. Having listened to the eulogies and also to the choice of songs that goes with the eulogy, not usual for a funeral, but we put it together with the eulogy. There is many things to remember, especially many good memories. So these are the things that you should cherish, and allows you to go on. I don't encourage people to forget, but to remember. But remember in a very good way, with the good way that the faith helps us to do so, and it also helps us to keep on going. Even difficult memories turn out to be good, being forced to go to the army. But it's now a good memory. Seychelles is always a passport to get out of trouble. So it seems. So it's things like this, and I suppose when the family can meet up to remember Serge and Marie-Agne, is to share the good memories together, laugh about it. Perhaps you might cry a little bit in the beginning, but then things will move on with time. And most of all, what has to be in our hearts is a big thank you. No? Thank you to Serge and Marie-Agne for all that they were to their family, to each and every one of you who are here. They must have held a very special place in your hearts. We thank them for what they are, and we thank God for giving us, for giving them to us. God is good in all the time. Georges, he said 58 years they were together. And they're not going to stop being together. That's the amazing thing. If we look at it, it's a difficult situation. I mean, leaving us so close together shows that perhaps they could not be separated. So the 58 years did not stop. It keeps on going for eternity. That is something we can only have when we have faith. And faith allows us to look at this in a very different light and be happy for them as their love story endures. I'm not sure if there are pressure cookers in heaven or red fiberglass minimums. Is that it? No? Yeah? But I'm sure there are many, many things that will keep them going and keeps us going, because faith gives us the promise and the hope that one day we will meet again. That is an amazing, we will meet again. And all these stories will continue and they will never end. So we keep on praying together. We ask the Lord to bless you all in a very special way as we remember Serge and Marie-Agne. We can stand up. Almighty and ever-living God, in you we place our trust and hope. In you the dead, whose bodies were temples of the Spirit, find everlasting peace. As we take leave of Serge and Marie-Agne, give our hearts peace in the firm hope that one day they will live in the mansion you have prepared for them in heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the peace of God, who surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. So we express our deepest sympathy to the members of the family.
Just a view.
When I die, hallelujah, bye.